This is how the common ion effect affects molar solubilities. What is the molar solubility of lead 2 bromide in each solution below? We're given a KSP value. We'll start with water. Lead bromide solid, when put into water, makes a little bit of lead 2 plus and a little bit of 2 bromides. When we initially start, we have some solid and none of either ion. This will be minus x, plus x, and plus 2x. And when we are finished, we will have some minus x, x, and 2x. All right, my KSP is going to be equal to my lead concentration times my bromide concentration squared. So that is going to be equal to x times 2x squared, which is equal to 4x cubed, and I will set that equal to the KSP, which I'm given as 6.3 times 10 to the minus 6. When I solve for x, I get the value 1.2 times 10 to the minus 2 molar. And x, of course, serves as my molar solubility. Alright, let's try the next one. Lead bromide. And I'm just writing this out for you for consistency's sake. It does help to see where the variables line up. So here is my reaction. Okay, now this time things are a little bit different. We start out with sub-zero and 0.15. Because remember, lithium bromide delivers one mole of bromide for every one mole of lithium bromide. So that 0.15 goes here. Okay. That's going to change things a little bit. So this on the delta rho is minus x, plus 2x. And this will wind up being some minus x, and 0.15 plus 2x. Okay? Now, this time, when I write my KSP, I'm going to not write it out in gory detail this time, since you've already seen it once. I can write 6.3 times 10 to the minus 6th is equal to the way I've represented my lead, which is x, times the way I am representing my bromide squared. Now, what I'm going to do at this point to make my math easier is assume that the 2x is negligible compared to my 0.15. So I'm going to simplify this as x times 0.15 squared. And we can check later and see if this was right. So I have to take 6.3 times 10 to the minus 6, divide it by 0.15 squared, and that should give me my value of x, which turns out to be 2.8 times 10 to the minus 4th molar. So was this value negligible compared to 0.15? Yeah, I think it was. It's certainly much smaller. Okay? Alright, last one. Once again, we'll write the old reaction. Okay. Initially, I start out with some, and notice that I am starting out with some lead 2 plus. That goes here. So I need to put 0.25 here and nothing on my delta rho minus x plus x plus 2x. Okay. And on my final row, this will be some minus x, 0.25 plus x, and 2x. Okay, once again, 6.3 times 10 to the minus 6, which is my KSP, is going to be equal to 0.25 plus x times 2x quantity squared. Once again, this could get into very horrible math, but let's make the assumption that this is negligible. Okay, let's try it again. See if it works out for us. Okay, so I can simplify this to 0.25 times 4x squared. Okay, so if I can just take 6.3 times 10 to the minus 6, 0.25 times 4 is 1, isn't it? That's equal to x squared. So I will take the square root of both sides, and x turns out to be... The x turns out to be 2.5 times 10 to the minus 3 molar, which is honestly pretty negligible compared to 0.25. It's, you know, in the thousands place. So that is my molar solubility when I have another common ion, lead 2 plus present. And that's how you do that.